Dear students of the University of Siena, the rapidity of the spread of the coronavirus infection is raising growing concerns. In this context, extraordinary measures are needed, the planning of which has been supported by the same scientific knowledge that we are committed to teach daily in our classrooms and further develop in our research laboratories. For once, politics seems to literally follow what scientists suggest to do, and I want to consider it as a positive sign for the legitimation of science and knowledge that we often claim. Over the last weeks, with the revolution of the restrictive measures, the University of Siena has tried to limit this comfort suffered by our students. We did it by keeping well in mind the goal of allowing you to proceed regularly with your careers. But we also had to consider to ensure safe environments and conditions for everyone to carry out any activity. With the engagement of professors, technicians, administrators, and teaching tutors, we will continue to do so in the coming weeks until the emergency situation is finally overcome. And we trust in your understanding to accept the inconveniences that will inevitably occur. Now, allow me to address one further but very important recommendation. I know very well that the life of students is not made only by lessons, study, and exams, but it's also characterized by the desire to socialize and to enjoy your free time. It is one of the pleasant parts of your adventure as a university student, and it is what makes our university, hosted in a medieval city campus, so attractive for the thousands of students who have decided to study in Siena. But in recent weeks, the situation that the country is facing, engaged in contrasting the spread of COVID-19, requires different behaviors. We need to put aside our social attitudes for a moment and limit our desire for aggregation. We need to live our lives mostly into our houses rather than outdoor in our beautiful squares and streets. We need to minimize contacts and gatherings in order to make them return to be as fun and exciting once the emergency is over. We need to exercise moderation and respect for those rules that have been designed by listening to the scientists who have dedicated their entire life to study and research. Following those rules means respecting science, but it also means respecting what you are all studying to become: researchers, doctors, but also lawmakers, engineers, economists, or philosophers. Following those rules means respecting the country and the city we love, because we were born here or because it is hosting us with affection. But it also means respecting your own future, or at least what you think it can become. It means respecting the dream you are working to make come true. Finally, following those rules means respecting those who are working in hospitals, facing the emergency, driven by the passion for their work that in these moments turns into a real mission. I trust in your sense of responsibility, in your love for the present and for the future, so that we all adopt consistent behaviors with the seriousness of the moment we are experiencing. If we follow those rules, everything will be all right. Thank you for your attention.